guys, welcome back to Alexa 360. Yeah. Sí? 360. Kitty run, run, kitty run, run. Today I am your amiga Latina. We are here at Casa Latina, which is this really amazing, authentic restaurant in Hongdae, Seoul, South Korea. I frequent here a lot actually for this incredible food. I'm excited. Today is gonna be a little bit of like a educational mukbang, if you will. But I'll be informing you a little bit about these foods because I learned a little bit here and there. I just wanna share the culture with you guys because I'm currently surrounded by Latin American culture quite frequently. So share the knowledge, spread the love, and eat some good food. You know, for all of my Latin American and Spanish speaking friends, there might be a little something, something coming out on the horizon, and what I mean by that is, pero si le ponen la canción, la dona depresión tonta, llorando lo comienza a llamar. Cut. Look out for the rest of that in the future. Ooh. So this is like a legit mojito?
Hell yeah!
We're gonna start out with the empanadas de carne chilena. In Chile, empanadas are a staple part of the national cuisine, commonly consumed in large quantities during the country's National Day celebrations. Many Chileans consider this to be their most representative dish. The most common type of Chilean empanada is what is referred to as empanada de pino. It is a baked empanada filled with diced or ground beef, sauteed onions and spices, half of a hard-boiled egg, an olive, and raisins, although the latter is not liked by a sizable portion of the population. Raisins? Nah. Argentine empanadas are often served during parties and festivals as a starter or main course. Shops specialize in freshly made empanadas with many flavors and fillings. Every region of Argentina has its own characteristic variant. Example, those of Salta are small, juicy, and spicy, and contain potatoes, peppers, and ground chili. The Jujuy variant adds peas and garlic. Ecuador too! Ecuadorian empanadas are called empanadas de viento, and often fried and filled with stringy cheese and sometimes a touch of onion. Granulated sugar is often sprinkled on top after cooking. Wow! Whoa! Oh, 여기 식당 실장님이. Oh my god. 최고, 최고다. Oh my god. Wow. The fact is, this is actually a very difficult and complicated thing to make. So the fact that we even have it here, it's like, wow. Bandeja paisa is a typical meal popular in Colombian cuisine, especially of the Antioquia department and the paisa region. The main characteristic of the dish is the generous amount and variety of food in a traditional bandeja paisa, which is red beans cooked with pork, white rice, carne molida, which is ground meat, chicharrón, fried egg, plantain, plátano maduro, chorizo, arepa, and hogao, sauce, morcilla, avocado, and lemon. It is served in a platter or tray. All right, next we're gonna talk about the milanesas. It's a South American variation of cotoleta, where generic types of meat breaded cutlet preparations are known as milanesa. The milanesa was brought to the southern cone by Italian immigrants during the mass immigration that created the Italian diaspora between 1860 and the 1920s. Next, we're gonna hop into the anticuchos. Anticuchos are popular and inexpensive meat dishes that originated in the Andes during the pre-Columbian era, basically during the Incan Empire. The modern dish was adapted during the colonial era between the 16th and 19th centuries and can now be found in Peru, actually. Anticuchos can be found on street carts and in street food stalls. Anticucheras. These are tostones o patacones. Green, unripe plantains are peeled, sliced lengthwise, diagonally, or widthwise, and then fried twice. The raw slices of plantains are fried for 1 to 2 minutes on each side until they are golden in color and removed and patted to remove excess cooking oil. They are called patacones in Panama, Colombia, Ecuador, Costa Rica, and Peru, and tostones in Cuba, Nicaragua, Puerto Rico, and Dominican Republic. And before we forget, this is my bestest friend here, the mojito. The mojito actually originated in Cuba, actually, and it actually had medicinal purposes back in the day. Basically, way, way back when this was first originated, people thought it had medicinal properties due to the ingredients that were in it. So before we start, a little toast. Para arriba, para abajo, para centro, para dentro. Whoop! That is so good! Oh, that is so good. Time to eat. I'm going to begin with the empanadas de carne chilena, aka my favorite thing that I get here. Like, every time I come here, I get these. so dang good. Every time I come here, it's so good. So we also have some pebre along with these empanadas de carne chilena. Top this off, and it's falling apart because it's so flaky. I'm very excited about the milanesa because I'm just gonna cut into a chunk of this. Like I'm getting a hug from Jesus. So American food wise, I don't know what this would be the equivalent to, but it kind of reminds me of like tonkatsu, like that kind of thing. So
it's good.
I don't even know how to describe it, but it's very different from what you'd expect in Korea. You would not come to Korea and expect to eat meat like this.
If you come to Korea, come to Casa Latina. It's very, very good. And now I'm eating the papas fritas.
Papitas, these are mine. Now we're gonna jump into the mystical, the magical, the alluring bandeja paisa. Ooh. I'm very excited about this because one, I love avocado, but there's also arepa. We got the chorizo,
I'm excited. I'm gonna
take a little bite of everything now and shake it all out. I've had this before, but it's just, My hands are clean, but I'm going to take the arepa. Ooh, she's thick. One and a two and a three. I feel the presence of God in this chilies tonight. This is so good. But I'm gonna jump real quick into the anticuchos just so we don't have like them sitting out for too long in the elements. So what I'm gonna do is take a little sip of Mr. Mojito first. Oh, it's so good. Tastes like summer. It's not summer yet, but we're close. Let's begin. It's just so good. I wish you could be sharing my experience right now. Like, 한국에 살고 계시면 꼭 Casa Latina 오세요. So good. Korean barbecue, there's still a lot of fat on the meat typically. When you get it, sometimes it's very fatty. Like, you get a chunk of meat like this big, but literally this half will be just a chunk of fat. I don't see any fat on these. They took like just the meat basically. So I think that's what the difference is in barbecue style, but also typically when you barbecue stuff in Korea, there's no seasoning unless you get like yangnyeom, which is like a marinated style of meat. But this has a whole bunch of stuff on it, but it's so good. I grew up eating a lot of stuff like this. Like we had family friends from Bolivia. And so we would do like Bolivian style, like grilling a cookout. It's like you would do the steak, put some like lime on it, some like salt. It was good. So this, it brings back memories. This is the tostones o patacones. See, I have never tried this before. Very excited. Let me get a sip of Mr. Mojito. Oh, so good. Okay, here we go. That's good. That's really good, actually. Thank you guys for joining me on this episode of Alexta. Alexta? Who dat? Who dis? Who dis? Alexa 360. Always happy to eat. Good food's always good. Makes me happy. Yeah. Make sure you check out my channel. Please watch the other videos if you don't mind. Let's see, make sure you like, subscribe, hit that bell for notifications, share the video, give me a nice comment, give me a thumbs up. You don't have to, you're not obliged to. You have free will to do what you want, but I'm just suggesting it. Let me get another sip of Mr. Mojito here. Keep your eyes peeled. Things are coming to you in the future. Pero hice todo este llanto por nada. Ahora soy una chica mala, you know? You know, you know? Okay, catch you on the flip side. Adios!
Oh. Muchos de la milanesa.
Ah, gracias. Gracias, muchas gracias. Como.
Bueno, aquí hay una extra por si acaso. Chilenas, empanadas veganas.